Oh, that's nice. Please do that.
Whole foot massage.
It's my second career. Whole foot massage.
Oh, my God.
I'm good at it.
And I have a small request that everybody in this room, so that I don't clear it, because I am insane, bipolar, bisexual, and bicuspid. But I will, I will sweetly and lovingly just clear the room. So just be still, because they can concentrate because they're young. I have menopause and tripolar. Here we go.
Tripolar.
I am tripolar. So please, none of this bullshit.
Me.
Just be still, and I won't clear the room. Loving you.
One.
This feels actually kind of like an estrogen-driven movie. No?
Gosh, you know, I don't know. I think it's both. I mean, with all those hot men and these fine women, I think you got a bit of estrogen and testosterone. It's really half and half. Think about it.
Hello.
Yeah, especially in the beginning.
Right?
I think.
Yeah.
I mean, the men are cute.
Oh, is there some? Oh,
The men are cute, but let's face it, women rule.
That's true. We're the strong ones. Absolutely.
Well, actually, David was admitting his wife came in to help him recut the scenes with Boris because they weren't quite hot enough for her taste.
Right. Lynn does not play, let me tell you. She said that shirt is coming off.
I remember.
And Lynn,
oh my God.
I didn't know Lynn was in the movie until I saw it.
And that was actually,
was so wonderful.
Do you know that was a complete just by chance? Because you know how it is, they had kids and the kids had to go home. And it worked out even more perfect that at the beginning of the movie, I discovered that the man, I think is the man of my dreams who's going to marry me, I think he's gonna marry me. Turns out he not only has a wife, but she's pregnant. And that gets a reaction.
The reaction of the audience when they see that is just, we don't wanna give it away.
Yeah, but that, but you know,
this will come out
early,
after the movie. Yeah, okay.
And that's early on, anyways.
Yes, it is.
But it's a much
pregnant?
Better surprise. Yeah,
she was pregnant.
Pregnant.
Yeah.
I was afraid
it
to
looked
ask
good.
No, we're actually all pregnant in the movie, all three of us.
Hey,
it's a totally different movie.
Listen.
We're carrying a lot of baggage. You get it? Okay, it's not a funny joke. Who cares?
Oh, it was brilliant, darling.
I'm trying to be funny, and
it's
so hard.
Try.
You just be yourself, sweet self.
Be pretty.
Oh, you.
You and young. Yeah, she's
you don't
really
have
young.
To be perfect when you're young. All you have to do is be beautiful, young, and fabulous. Hello.
So do you have to add more talents than, because you started beautiful, young, and fabulous.
Yeah.
You're still pretty young, relatively speaking.
Well, I have a young spirit, I can tell you that. And I still, you know, black don't crack. So
I think.
I have no shame. And somebody in a Rite Aid the other day said, I want the name of your doctor. I was like, find the scar. Go on. Find it.
You said
that was the highest compliment. Jesus. I mean, it's the highest compliment. Look, you have to stay healthy. You know, vegetables, fruit,
this woman
water.
Walks 7 miles a day.
Yeah, well, not
a
day.
Well, if you do it on a day period.
Once when I was running from a man.
7 miles in a month.
Once when I was running from a man, it was 7 miles.
But you were playing a diva adult, you know, the queen since you were a kid, really.
Well, you know.
That's your energy.
Listen,
almost.
They call me the black mother of Hollywood. And in all serious, there's a responsibility to represent the African-American middle-aged woman. We're Mother Earth, we are. And I always try to honor them and make them real. They are sassy, they are, hard. There's tough love there. And Catherine, my character, you know, she's very insecure and she's old school and she wants her daughters to be safe and settled. And she forgets about love for a couple of seconds, having been married many times herself.
I think that there's a romantic in your character, though. There's this, because you had that love, there's always that drive for more love, do you know?
Yeah.
And that search, and I think that that's what you're instilling in your daughters, is find that marriage, because that seems like the ultimate, to get a man to sacrifice.
Absolutely.
And put a ring on the finger
and
is
Catherine,
the ultimate.
She loves her daughters, but when one is desperate, as Catherine is, you forget.
Yeah.
You forget. You just want
not other people's feelings.
Absolutely. Oh, you have feelings, do you?
Right, you're trying to get to the goal.
I have an agenda.
Absolutely.
Should you guys have conversations about this before you make the movie, or do you even have time on a picture like this? Short schedule and...
Laura, we rehearsed a lot, yes?
No, we didn't.
Not really.
We didn't?
Personally, for me, I
was rehearsing in my trailer alone.
But I think that's actually, well, I think that's the best way to do it, though. Go ahead.
I agree with you. I think sometimes the initial meeting is makes it really authentic. But I feel like you have a very mothering nature to you. So it's easy to just jump in that with you. And you were very, very warm and loving to me, so it's easy to jump in that with
it
you.
It was easy.
We did. We all
loved the mother-daughter relationship was easy because we loved each other in real life.
We did.
And you can only bring real life to the art. I mean, let's get real.
I do agree. And I think that's the magic in making movies is that you do all that work on your own, mm-hmm. and then you come to set and you surprise each other. Mm-hmm. And that's when you can really be mm-hmm. in the moment. Lauren doesn't know what I'm going to do, and I don't know what she's going to do. And so that's where it gets exciting, and not it doesn't become over rehearsed or you can see it coming, do you know? And we don't even, and for us, it's the most fun as an actor, right? Is that because you don't know and you're really in the moment. So
absolutely.
I've never been one for rehearsing for film. I feel like you should do all that work on your own for sure, but then when you come together, leave a little surprise.
The both of them, as myself, were naturals. So that always brings another element. I mean, it's, you know, you can be method. You know, my generation, we went to school and majored in theater arts and you know, took the steps opposed to the elevator. And this generation, I think, brings the magic of, not that you didn't go to school or study the arts, but there's a study over here and there's a natural over here. And I felt that they both did the lay work, but when they came to set, it was just natural. And it was very professional and it was beautiful. No.
So that's like a major compliment coming from you. Like,
well, I pay attention. I pay attention. And
you?
I always. And I look all right, just a little. But I want to always give them, I always think I'm teaching them. But they come loaded, and I admired that in both of you.
Gosh, really, you know, one of my most fun scenes was when you come and wake me up in my bed.
That was a good scene. I love that scene.
So I'm like, we need to establish boundaries, Mom.
There were
Dude,
no like, boundaries. I mean, you know.
Just right in.
Jumping in bed
having the
with
best
her.
Dream ever. Mom's there. That's how aggressive my mom is in the movie.
Yeah, but Catherine was desperate.
Yes, Catherine. Not playing games.
A mess.
So you have this massive cast of all these great actors. I mean, it's as I was saying before, the number of people in the movie is almost too much to fit on the poster. Like another, you need a second poster for the rest of the cast.
Look, I'm not going to lie. I couldn't get on the poster. I mean, I've done 63 films. They said, no, it's all taken. But the bar, it did. I swear to God, I'm not on the poster. But, you know, I always do know that when they get in there, they'll see me too.
They'll hear from you quickly.
This business is so
remember,
brutal.
It is a brutal business. Yes, it is.
But you are unquestionably the lead here, Paula.
Thanks.
I mean, it's your movie. I don't know if there's a day that you weren't shooting, but you seem to be in pretty much everything. Is that great? Is that fun? Is that a change of pace that you like? Is that...
I mean, I love the character. I don't look at it in terms of how long I'm going to be in the movie. Really, first thing for me in a film is, do I love the overall project? Because mm-hmm. to me, a movie is art, and it's the best kind of art form there is. It's painting and photography with these moving images. It's music, you know, and it's poetry and novels. You know, it's the writing of the script. It's all in one. That's why I've always loved film. So to do a great performance in a bad movie never made sense to me. I wanted to be a part of something that I really could be proud of. So that's most important than being on camera all the time.
She's the new It Girl.
Oh,
let's
thank
just
you very
face
much.
It. Clara Bow was the It Girl back then. She's the It Girl now.
Very sweet. Thank you.
But there's a responsibility besides the joy of it, there's a responsibility because if you have a bad day,
it was. I mean, listen, we tried to put as much as we could in this movie. And the great thing is that everybody that came to the film, Lauren, Jennifer, and the whole cast of everybody, was really passionate about it. Everybody gave their 100,000% to the film. Because we all really believed in the project.
And David,
that was exciting.
David said, set a mood on the set that was fun.
Yes.
I've been talking about David E. Talbert all day. He created an environment where you wanted to show up and give him your best. Every director's not like that. Yeah. There are a lot of technical directors. Mm. David was an artist director. And he'd always whisper in your ear. I loved that.
Yeah, you know, that's need everybody to know what you're doing when you're messing up.
And professionalism. It was great working with David.
Yeah, it really was.
It sounded like we were talking before with Boris, and apparently Boris gave him some instructions about how to shoot. Was he? I mean, it sounds like he was actually open to people adding to the mixture here.
That's what makes a great director. I mean, the thing is that movies take many people to make them. It's a collaborative art form. I mean, the actors were just one part of it, one small part, quite frankly. There's set design, there's lighting, there's the camera work, there's the editing that happens afterwards. You have to have respect for that, you know? And I forgot the question. What was you?
Just about David's tone on the set.
But that's what I think any great director does, is that he makes it collaborative, that you're always willing to listen to opinions. You know your vision, but if there's a better opinion, a smart man will listen to it, and a confident man. And that is what he was, and that was what was so impressive about him, is that he was always open, okay, let me hear it, let me see. Maybe that could be right. It wasn't even in the book. It wasn't the way I saw it, but now I can see it that way. Mm. And that's what really, I think, helped make the movie what it is. And really, our relationship so great is that I love the book, I love the script, I was on board. But of course, I'm opinionated. Too, you know, and I love that.
Oh yes, there were a lot of opinions from Paula.
Yes,
and they were wonderful.
Thank you.
And she was fabulous. Now, I'm being paid to say that.
Oh gosh, not by me, I hope, because I don't have the money.
I know that,
No, but that was, it was a very collaborative experience, and it was great, and I thank him for that. And I think all of us, because I think he allowed all the actors to do that. He'd do the take that's on book, right?
Yeah, and then
take for yourself.
He makes you feel valued.
Yeah.
That's important.
You take it off the page, and he allowed us to do that, feel comfortable doing that, because he was directing and writing.
That's right.
So you,
and that's a difficult thing for a director-writer to do.
Yeah.
And you went back to the book.
I had read the book earlier, but my manual is always a script.
Right.
And I always keep the original script, and I keep every draft. It's something I learned actually from Denzel Washington. He always like, let me go back to the original, because that was your first intention as a writer. Mm-hmm. There's got to be something in that original script. Sometimes there are versions in between, forget about it. But that first draft is always there with the draft that we're shooting with, for me. Mm-hmm.
Because that was the flow.
Yes.
That's the flow, and where a writer sits down and becomes the character in order to write the character.
Yeah,
and you're absolutely right. It was the first intention.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Well, I learned that through Paula and through Denzel. Thank you, Denzel. I will keep all my original scripts because I throw them away.
Listen, Tom Hanks said to me, if you don't believe it, don't say it.
Right. Mm.
That's so true.
And David allowed us to come off the page and make it our own. And most writers are not that flexible.
That's very true.
Absolutely.
Which allows us to actually, for me as an actor, to give more of myself and to make it more real.
And it makes it more real. Mm. It makes it, that's, you want, and then they can edit it. You know, they'll probably take a take from when you're on the book, and then that take when you were doing it your way. And that's the truth. That's the movie magic, I think. That's what, and especially in comedy. In comedy, you have to let room for improv and have fun.
I think so too.
Yeah.
And the other piece, having come from theater, okay, I just lost my train of thought.
I told you that was more edited.
Hold on, that coming from theater. You just said something. What'd you say?
Improvisation, movie magic.
Oh yeah. Well, here's the thing.
Okay.
Oh, the editing. You know, being from the theater, when you. After Places, that's it. You're on. And that magic is, you can't compare that magic to anything, being right there in the moment. And when you come to Hollywood and you see that somebody else controls that performance, that editor.
That's very true.
Before and after takes, I always say a little something funny. So he doesn't cut me completely out.
kids. Always kids.
I mean, really.
Come so, was there anything surprising in the seeing the final cut of this picture?
The end scene, to me, I was surprised to see.
Don't give it away. I mean, that's a funny. That's a great little tack.
All I know was it's fabulous.
That's a really tacked-on funny ending with.
Don't tell.
I know.
Oh yes.
That part, I was surprised. That's right. I wasn't expecting it.
The audience is in for a lot of surprises.
Yes.
It's not predictable. It is not a predictable movie. So that's what makes it exciting, absolutely.
Because you never know who she's going to end up with either. You know, as she goes on this search, it's like...
The formula is kind of thrown out the window. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, it's certainly the beginning, middle, and end, but there's a lot of twists and turns in this movie that you don't expect.
I think people will be surprised with what you do decide to do, because even me watching it, knowing the script, I was like, she should make this decision.
A lot of people think that.
Yeah.
Vagina. Yeah. That's all I'm going to say. A lot of people are like, moms to expect you. They're like, I don't know.
Well, that's the poetry.
I was looking pretty good.
Yeah, that's the poetry of this film, because... you don't know where it's going, and every scene allows you to go, as all romantic comedies, it allows you to go on a journey with your own romances. Mm. What would I do? It's all there on screen.
Well, the whole last decision really is a decision, which is unique in a romantic comedy. Yes. It really is a choice between two things, as opposed to feeling you have to do one or the other. And, you know, different people make different decisions.
I think that that was important to me, and that's something I talked a lot about with David, was making her a modern woman. I'm so tired of, and forgive me, Mom, but you have these successful friends who have done so much, and they're like, and then they say, well, is she married? Does she have a child?
Oh, my God.
And as if that makes everything else null and void, to know that we can't enjoy a woman's success unless she has that, too. I find that very old-fashioned, and it wasn't something that I thought we should, you know, push into. Now, listen, go ahead.
Here's my answer to that. I think in this day and age, if a woman knows who she is, you do not have to be married. You do not have to have children in this day and age. Now, it's wonderful. I've just had some children come into my life, some very young babies with my work with children. But, of course, I can send them home right after that. But these are modern times. Women are becoming the breadwinners, some of them. And it's a new day. So I love that Paula wanted her to be, you know, free and smart. This is a very smart film, you know. Mm-hmm. So I was very excited to see what David was doing with the character.
That at the end of the day, that when there's kind of two happy endings. Mm-hmm. The one happy ending is that she discovers herself and says, I don't need your approval anymore. I don't care what everybody else thinks. I need to work on loving myself, and I'm okay with being alone. I don't need a man to define me. And then, of course, just like life, the minute you stop looking, he appears. But what's really great is a man that appears. Because you guys got control of this?
It's going to just run as in full, so. But people will...
Forget it.
Never
Let's just put
mind.
It this way.
But you're just when you gonna edit this.
No.
We're
running out of
time. Oh, for God's sake.
Oh, we're in trouble.
Let me sing a song.
Wait a minute. I lost my train of thought and everything.
This is why I've been so quiet and cute.
You know,
thank you. Look,
I had to add that. That's the only funny thing.
You know what? I'm gonna make this too long for you to air it that way.
I've been trying to be intelligent and speak eloquently. Oh, that's over. Now that I know this is not gonna be edited. How's everybody? All right now.
Well, I'll just
he said you can curse.
Absolutely. Well, fuck him.
Well, I don't want to give anything else away. I'll
That's
just say
really,
two happy
done.
Endings.
That's
and we just want to say that at the end of the day, of course, it's wonderful to find a mate that you want to spend your life with and share your life with. But that should be the cherry on top. It shouldn't be the meal.
But what I want to say is I want Laura to talk now because she's the youngest and we don't want to ignore
I'm fine.
Her.
I'm, no, you guys, listen. I'm playing my position.
How do you feel about making the movie? What was some
I'm
of your
just
experience?
Learning
she should have been in it more. That's what it should have been.
Well, that's true.
Gorgeous
that's true.
Movie star she is. Yeah.
Up and coming starlet.
Yes.
Laura London.
Lauren, Jennifer.
Lauren, shit. But guess who I called? Wait a minute.
I cannot stand
it. Wait,
I waited
for you to say
Lauren
about it.
I've been saying Lauren all day. It's like that little Gabrielle, I call her, the union baby. She said, people look at and go, her name is Gabrielle. I'm like, well, you know. And she turned to somebody, she said, well, I let Jennifer do it. So. I listen, Laura. No, it's Lauren London. Lauren. God.
So speaking of modern women.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, come on. That was brilliant.
It was awesome. Honestly, it's awesome.
She waited so long. It was
beautiful. All the attention went to you for about 5 minutes because I mispronounced your name. So,
well, everyone's going to go to my face when you call me Laura. And I'm like.
All right, and listen, I've told everybody I'm menopausal, bipolar,
I saw you OCD, say anything.
Bisexual, bicoastal. All right, maybe not bisexual, but.
That was before.
There was a time in Chicago. There was that one time in Chicago. Look, there's nothing I could do. She was very forceful, but.
I'm just kidding.
No, I'm not. Anyway, go on.
Life is just about experiences. That's all I'm gonna say.
You're 56. You can say anything you want.
Yes, including calling me Laura. It's fine.
Thank you very much.
Oh, great button.
Okay.
So now I've lost my train of thought.
That was the point.
That is the longest interview that
really?
I have ever cut ever.
It's a long show. A half hour.
Half hour.
Oh, all right, well, here's the song. Talking?
We were not properly prepped.
All right. Well, what's your favorite song? We'll have to sing.
We need you on camera, buddy.
No,
you need to get on camera.
Somebody forced that issue once, but not today. Okay, so do you feel like the it girl at this point?
Not at all. The thing is life is funny, and I'm sure that you guys can all understand. It takes guts, right, to get into this business, and yet you're fraught with so many insecurities. And when you're by yourself alone, you feel. I hate myself sometimes, period, you know? I'm very self-critical. I don't like to watch myself. I don't watch playback.
We're going to work on that.
I have issues, you know?
I'm not having it. Well, thank you. I've got issues,
listen, it's always fun to hear, but then it goes in one ear and out the other, because, you know, it's such a long journey ahead. And I'm just so thankful to be in this film. Honestly, this is a dream come true for me. I'd wanted to be in this movie for years.
Are you a career thinker?
I'm not. You know, I just don't think that you can put science on this or intellectualize it. I'm an artist. I go with my gut. I go with passion. I go with what feels right
to
me.
It's too unpredictable.
To try to manipulate it, first of all, it's impossible because as an actor, you have no power. But until you get to a certain place. But it's true.
We just schlep along. Stand over there on your mark. Jennifer, you're off your mark.
I mean, I'm sure at a certain point, yes, you can control it a bit, but I just really try to pick projects that I'm passionate about because it takes so much of your time, that you better love it.
Yeah.
Right.
Is the world giving you a sense that you have a little more control over which mark you stand on, where you go?
You know what? You have to take it for yourself. I mean, I think that you have to make a choice. For me, I'll be less famous and I'll have less money, so that I can do the things that I love to do, and not do things that don't move me.
Yeah, you come to an age, and I won't say this out loud. Really, as you guys, if I don't say everything out loud, you have to come to a place, and you will, and so will you, but it comes with maturity, being able to take in the compliments. Mm. It's hard because we're complimented so much that sometimes we don't know what's real and what's not real. But one day you both will look in the mirror and say, you know what? I'm good.
Mm-hmm.
And
I hope so.
Yeah, right. You will. It comes with maturity.
But that's the thing that's hard being an actor, is that there's also so much criticism. There's so much rejection. I mean,
oh,
I'm sure
God,
that we
yes.
could all talk about the amount of times you just
when
you
I didn't get Saturday Night Live,
getting that role, you didn't get it,
so
and then it
roles.
Breaks your heart, and then you tell you, well, you're just not this enough, you're not that enough.
Years ago,
that's the tough part. About
I didn't get
game.
Saturday Night Live.
Yeah,
I went to Central Park. Fell on my knees. What's the sheet metal? Fell on my knees and then fell flat on my face and sobbed. I didn't care who was walking around. I could not believe that I didn't get Saturday Night Live. As funny as I am, but
I can't
you
believe
work,
it either.
Yeah, well, right. You work through the pain by believing that you are good.
Yeah, of course. There's that.
You work through the pain because, and you get up because you know we always feel the next job will never come. Well, I'm here to tell you it does, and both of you won't work because you're talented. Beauty is one thing. Anybody can be pretty, but talent will out. And nothing is wasted. God, I'm deep. I love myself. Come on, Killer.
I went to church.
You made a big mistake Saturday Night Live, okay? I'm just going to say that.
Mom, yeah, okay. Sometimes the people in power aren't the smartest either. Like,
oh, speak on it, but not too loud.
Oh, my God.
Because I still need a job.
We love you. All you people in power, you guys are so smart.
Love you guys.
Well, I don't care anything about them.
So is it harder, do you think, for you being a female actor, that there is so much emphasis on what you look like in terms of beauty and whatever?
Of course. Come on now. Come on. Yeah. That's why I'm going to lie to you. I'm glad I got the mother role, so I don't have to stay all skinny and shit. Somebody got time to be skinny and shit. I was never the ingenue. I'll be your mother. Not that kind of money. Did I tell that joke already? People say, Jennifer, why do you always play the mother? I say, okay, let me get it right. Okay, he's not editing. All right. Take two. They say, Jennifer, why do you always play the mother? I said, for that kind of money, I'll play the daddy. All right.
It's good.
Yes, it's a good line.
I've heard that joke before.
Black mother of Hollywood. London. See, I got your last name right.
That's fly.
London,
that work.
I want you to talk, because you're too cute and shy. Go on
I'm
with those
shy.
Dimples. Look at her dimples.
I'm not shy. I'm really just taking it all in. I'm watching you guys and learning, because I would love to be in one and two seat one day. So I'm just watching.
I'm always be honest. Just look at the camera and say, over here, look at the camera and say, over here, you got me? Yeah.
Yeah, when we do a scene together next time and I'm talking to you, just go like this to the camera.
Absolutely. And when you're in interviews like this, just look in so they'll remember this interview. I am a whore. These are the kind of things you have to say. I mean, well,
I'm
maybe
still
not.
A virgin. What are you talking about?
Well,
you have a child.
Hello. I don't know how to
marry. Has anybody read the Bible?
Yeah, by the way, I am looking for, I'm not looking for a man, but I love myself. If there is a male out there who loves you, if you love yourself, call me. I don't know how you'll find my number.
I know, secret. They tore me to shreds.
I love that nobody's listening to anybody.
Sorry. It's typical
I
actors.
To anything. I love that today it's all talking about ourselves. I love this shit, man.
And
I
just love. I'm so stressed out about it. I'm like, oh.
Oh, honey, I can't wait to say something else about myself. Oh,
okay,
it's
look at
sick.
It working. Come on, man.
Okay, so I started on the road.
It's on you now, babe.
1957.
But isn't it like the polar opposite of what you do when you're actually doing the movie? Isn't it all about listening to each other when you're on set?
No, I have to be very honest with you. I really do try, because I play everybody's mother, I really try to bring many different levels to each of those women and honor them for who they are. I mean, that's just taking responsibility for being an artist and having people who have 9-to-5 jobs come and say, look at me for an hour and a half. Mm. There's a great responsibility in that. And if you got, 1,000 people sitting in a movie theater, 2,000 eyes are looking at you. There's a responsibility. There really is.
Well, it's funny because Paula has actually, in this run of these great roles you've had, you've kind of become a feminist icon almost. I mean, you're a very strong woman in these movies and still manage to be very feminine. This one, the goofiest character you've probably played.
Yeah, sure.
She's a little lost, but you've played some very strong women in the last few years.
She's a little lost.
She's a little lost and she finds herself. But no, the thing is, I think you can be a strong woman without being a man. That always frustrated me when a woman is trying to play a man. I think that there's so much power in being a woman. I mean, you can still have physical strength, but also your femininity is a power. Mm-hmm. And I really feel like society has made it a vulgar thing to embrace your femininity because I think they're so scared of it because it's so damn powerful. And I think I'd like for more young women and people to just embrace their femininity and feel the power of it. And I think that through that, without trying to be like a man, that's how we'll rise up.
I think the most difficult thing for an actor to do is to bring that thing called vulnerability. Mm. I mean, when you splatter yourself out, yes, we play characters, but you're naked. Mm-hmm. you're naked and you're looking at yourself and you're 8 feet tall on a screen, you've got to give it. You've got to be believable. The audience will catch you. Yeah. If you come out of a out of character for a second, you might as well just be looking into the camera and taking them out of it. It seems easy. It really does once we've landed what we're doing and who we are in the film. But my God, it is not easy getting there. Mm. That's why if you get into this business, and I say this to young people right now, you have to love it with your entire molecular structure. And if you don't, please listen to your girl. Keep the fuck out of this business. It'll kill you. I swear to God, it'll just kill you. Have you almost died?
Every day.
And yeah, we die
every
day.
I don't want to talk about it today.
But we rise. We rise.
Right.
It's true.
The three of you seem pretty happy, though, I gotta say.
We are.
Liz, I don't think you should leave your house if you're not happy.
Look,
I mean,
we're
I see people like,
why are you smiling so much? I'm like,
because I'm out in public and I'm not here to rain on people.
When you're at work,
and we're celebrating. This is a celebration.
Yeah.
And we are.
This is a celebration of the work we did.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You know, it's a lot of hard work we did, especially, I mean, you're in. That's a lot of hard work. It's I can't say it enough. It's a lot of hard work. This is the easy part.
So Lauren gets the last word.
Very good.
And that was my point. Okay.
All right.
She waited.
She was fighting all of us.
You little sneaky Laura person. Laura.
London is just fabulous.
London
is it. Yeah, I like that. London.
London.
She just changed
it to
London.
I'm okay with that.
One name.
London.
Just
be her name.
Just
be her name.
Ladies and gentlemen, London. I like that.
Me too. Listen, I might switch it up.
Yeah, I do. Bye.
Peace.